So we'll be doing a quick review of the Whoop Labs timer for basically micros. I downloaded it from the Play Store this morning. Here it is on my tablet. I also put it on my phone, but I'm gonna use my tablet so I can use my phone for recording this video. It's a little timer. I'll launch it right now. You can see it's supposedly a motion detector. Simply a motion detector that detects as your quad as it passes over the camera of the phone or the tablet in this instance. You can set the lap count, start delay, which is a little timer like a countdown timer. And then you can also set the rear camera to use the rear camera instead of the front camera of your phone. There's a voice that says how many laps you've done and the lap info, which is basically a lap timer difference from your previous lap. So I'll be using my King Kong 100 because I don't have a Tiny Whoop yet. I'm going to set the tablet down here on the table. I have it also paired to a little Bluetooth speaker so you can easily hear the timer. I'm going to be doing a couple laps inside my house just to make sure it works. So let me just set the phone right here. Hopefully it doesn't topple over.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Whoop Labs ready. Whoop Labs timer started. Lap 1, 19.537 seconds. Lap 2, 10.903 seconds, 8.633 seconds under previous lap. Lap 3, 7.65 seconds, 3.253 seconds under previous lap, last lap. Lap 4, 10.947 seconds, 3.296 seconds over previous lap, Whoop Labs stop.
Took the quad outdoors now. We're gonna do a little quick test in a little park. Since the camera is motion, I'm sorry, since the app is motion activated, I wanna do a quick test on how it fares in daylight. So that's why I'm doing it in a little park here. I'll be setting up the app or the tablet here on the floor, and let's see how it does detecting the quad as it passes by. Okay, Whoop Labs. Okay, let's set the lap time. I'm sorry, number laps, and then let's press start. Okay, so the tablet is set up there.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Whoop Labs ready. Whoop Labs timer started. Lap 1, 18.711 seconds. Lap 2, 8.732 seconds, 9.979 seconds under previous lap. Lap 3, 18.426 seconds, 9.693 seconds over previous lap, last lap. Lap 4, 9.191 seconds, 9.234 seconds under previous lap, Whoop Labs stopped.
So this is what it looks like after you complete your laps. It says lap complete and then your best time. Oops, sorry about that. Your best time, it'll show it. And you can go to a lap summary page to look at your times. So, yeah, not bad at all. Although, there were a couple of times that it didn't detect the quad. I'm not sure if it's because of the bright daylight, but anyway, since this is going to be probably mostly used for Tiny Whoops, which will be indoors, it should be fine. I think it's probably either my tablet, which is a pretty crap tablet, has a pretty crap camera, so I think if you place it on a better phone, on a newer tablet or a phone, it should detect the laps pretty nicely. So, yep, so that's a quick review of the Whooplap apps from the Google Play Store. I believe it's available for both iOS and Android. I'm not sure how much it is on iOS, but it's a couple of bucks on the Play Store. I don't have an Apple device with me. But yeah, it's a great option for those of you who want to track your lap times using your Tiny Whoop or Micro, such as this one. Indoors or outdoors, it works. It misses a couple of laps, but obviously it's not a biggie. If you have a couple of friends and racing your micros, the greater option right now would be a TBS race tracker, because it can track two or more quads, I believe, using separate trackers as it tracks the VTX signal frequency off the quad as it flies by. But like I said, if you're alone and just want to be flying by yourself indoors or outdoors, you can use your smartphone, download this Whooplaps app. It's a great option for you guys. So yeah, if you like my video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and ask me any questions. I'll try to answer any comments and questions in the comment section. Thanks, you guys. Have fun flying.